Hi, this is Giuseppe Argenziano from Naples, Italy, and today I would like to talk to you about a new paper that was coming out in the New England Journal of Medicine quite recently, titled "The Rapid Rise in Cutaneous Melanoma Diagnosis." They are confronting with the well-known fact that we are seeing a kind of melanoma epidemic, in the last 20 years. Of course, we all know that melanoma was increasing dramatically in terms of incidence. What is also true is that the mortality remains stable. So these are the figures we know very well, and the authors try in this paper to analyze the reasons why we are confronting with this melanoma epidemic. They say actually that it's not due to an increased UV exposure in their view, but it's mostly due to increased diagnostic scrutiny. Well, this is, of course, we can agree on this because the more we look at the skin of our patients, the more we find melanoma, and that's for sure. One of the main reasons why we are able today to diagnose many more melanomas than in the past. What they say, although, is that at least a good proportion of these melanomas that are diagnosed much more easily today are not true melanomas, but they are in some way the result of overdiagnosis, meaning that some of them are actually not melanoma at all, and some of them are melanomas which will never be killing our patients. Clearly, we know very well that there is a certain proportion of melanomas that are very slow growing. We analyzed this problem a few years ago, and we found out that the great majority of the melanomas we see in our practice, fortunately, they are very slow growing. So there is pretty much a long time needed that this melanoma is going to kill our patient. But what is funny, although in this paper, are the conclusions. So the strategies that they suggest to reduce melanoma overdiagnosis. The first strategy they suggest is that more generally, dermatopathologists should reverse their tendency of lowering thresholds to diagnose melanoma. And then they say pathologists could also pursue linguistic de-escalation specifically for melanoma in situ. What does it mean? Should we not call this disease melanoma? We should call it, as they suggest, melanocytic neoplasm. So it's like saying, the basal cell carcinoma on the left, since it's a scleroderma basal cell carcinoma, it's more aggressive, so let's call it basal cell carcinoma, while the superficial basal cell carcinoma on the right, since will never be a problem for the patient, we should not call it basal cell carcinoma. Come on, this is the same disease. The only problem is the difference in terms of biologic tendency to create problems, So it's really a little bit funny what they suggest. But this is the most impressive suggestions. Dermatologists and primary care practitioners need to work to raise their threshold to biopsy. A simple approach, listen, would be to return to the threshold used in the past. That is, not to biopsy pigmented lesions with a diameter smaller than that of a pencil eraser of 6 millimeter. Can you imagine? So they are going to restoration and say, and they say, okay, we don't care about melanomas of less than 6 millimeter. And then they conclude the dermatoscope, which is an handheld device that magnifies skin abnormalities, has probably lowered thresholds to biopsy by highlighting subtle features in pigmented lesions. These features correlate poorly and inconsistently with biologic behavior, but are nonetheless increasingly labeled as melanoma. Thus, the dermatoscope may have literally magnified the problem of overdiagnosis. So basically, they suggest also not to use dermoscopy anymore. Can you imagine? So this is definitely a conclusion that it's not acceptable. In order to let you know why I say so, I show you a simple example. This is a couple that we saw a few years ago, husband and wife. I mean, can you imagine? They love each other pretty much. First, because they decided to get melanoma in the same body areas at the same time. And they came on February 14th in our clinic, believe it or not, so the day of San Valentine, which is the day of the lovers, you know. So what is the conclusion? The conclusion is that the lady had a melanoma in situ, so she's okay, and the husband had a melanoma of 1.3 millimeter. So it's a quite thin melanoma. Of course, it's in the range already that sometimes melanoma metastasis can occur. And can you imagine, after 5 years, this guy is now full of metastasis due to this melanoma of 1.3 millimeter. Can you imagine? And this is a melanoma of 7 millimeter in diameter. So I'm pretty sure that if we were able to diagnose this melanoma 6 months before or 1 year before, when it was 4 millimeter in diameter, then this guy would have been free of metastasis today. Okay, so the conclusion of this New England Journal of Medicine paper, definitely terrible. And in order to also to give you more proofs that these are conclusions which are not really acceptable, in the next video I will show you what was changing in terms of melanoma after the COVID lockdown. And with this, I thank you for your attention.